Hi guys, in this lesson we'll go into the five pillars of the well-architected framework. So again, what is this? Well, it's there to help you understand the pros and cons of decisions you make building on AWS. There are five pillars. Let's go into each of these in some detail. Firstly, we have the operational excellence pillar. This is about supporting the development of workloads on AWS. It's about gaining insight into your workload operations and improving your processes and procedures to make sure you're delivering value to your business. Now, the best practices are where you really need to take notice. These are the things that come up in exam questions, so you very well might see these phrases in the answers. Perform operations as code. So don't perform operations manually. Use tools like CloudFormation to automatically build your infrastructure. Make frequent, small, and reversible changes rather than big changes that are difficult to roll back. This helps you if something goes wrong, you can quickly roll back and try again. Refine operations procedures frequently, constantly reevaluate how you're doing things. Is there a better way? And anticipate failure. Big one that comes up a lot. Make sure you always anticipate what could go wrong. That's how you can prevent it from happening. And also make sure that you're able to recover from failure when it does happen. So learn from all operational failures. Make sure that you update your processes, work out why did it happen and what can I do next time. Then we have the security pillar. This is about protecting your data, systems, and assets and taking advantage of the cloud technologies that are available for you to secure your data. Best practices are implement a strong identity foundation. So make sure that your identity management systems, systems like IAM, like your identity federation, like your mobile and web application authentication systems, you got to get those right so that your identities are properly secured and users get access to what they need. Enable traceability so you can trace what's happening, where did things go wrong, what's happening here and what's happening there. Apply security at all layers. Don't just apply security at the perimeter. Make sure that every layer of your application and infrastructure has security applied. Automate security best practices. Automate as much as you can. The more you automate, the less human error you're likely to have. Protect data in transit and at rest. So think about encryption here. Remember, it's up to you to encrypt your data on AWS. You want to encrypt it as it's moving across a network in transit and at rest when it's stored in a storage system or in a database. Keep people away from data. Have the right access controls in place to secure your data access. Prepare for security events. So make sure that you're prepared in case anything happens, like malicious attacks, like distributed denial of service attacks. Next, we have the reliability pillar. This is about ensuring your workloads perform correctly and consistently as they're expected to for whatever they do. This includes the ability to operate and test the workload for its entire lifecycle. Best practices are automate recover from failure. So make sure that when something goes wrong, like a system fails, you can automatically recover. You don't need manual involvement. Think about Amazon EC2 auto-scaling. If a system fails, an instance fails, then it will be automatically replaced by auto-scaling and your load balancer will start distributing traffic to it. That's automatic recovery. Test recovery procedures. You always have to test. In the cloud, it's really easy to test your recovery procedures, including doing full disaster recovery testing. Lots of companies don't test their procedures until they really need to do it, and then they find they don't work. It's too late at that point. Scale horizontally to increase aggregate workload availability. Wherever possible, scale horizontally. Though some services require you to scale vertically, like for example, when you have an RDS database and you need to increase the write throughput, you have to use a larger instance size. But as you go up to larger instance sizes and you've got more traffic coming into that database, what happens if that one instance fails? You have a big problem. So of course, in that regard, you could have something like a multi-AZ failover. But even better, where possible, like for example, with DynamoDB or with EC2 instances, you can scale horizontally. And that means the failure of an individual component or system does not affect the overall application. Stop guessing capacity. another one that the cloud makes easy because we can dynamically and automatically change the amount of resources associated with the services we use. So we don't have to guess how much resource we need and then find out later on that we were wrong. If we are wrong, it doesn't matter so much in the cloud because we can adjust very easily. Manage change in automation. So implement change management procedures and automate as much as possible. Next, we have the performance efficiency pillar. This is about ensuring our resources are working to meet the requirements and changing as demand and as technologies evolve as well. Best practices are democratize advanced technologies. AWS wants you to leverage the technologies and services that they provide. They provide lots of amazing tools, managed services, event-driven architectures, serverless services. All of these kind of things can be built on AWS and utilized on AWS. And so use as much of that as possible because it delivers value to your business. Go global in minutes. This is one that, again, is very much a feature of the cloud, the ability to deploy your applications all over the world very easily. Use serverless architectures. Wherever possible, use serverless. It means you're not managing the underlying layer of infrastructure, managing patches, managing systems, and you are leveraging a higher level of service and you're able to scale more easily as well. Experiment more often. This is all about just experimenting and seeing what we can do. We can learn a lot by testing out different things, and it's easy to do in the cloud. So we can learn from what we do and then improve our processes, improve our performance and our operations. Consider mechanical sympathy. It's one of those strange phrases that AWS has. Essentially, it means that you need to understand the systems and the purpose of those systems that are available to you so that you can utilize them to their best effect. Lastly, we have the cost optimization pillar. This is all about making sure you're delivering value to your business at the lowest price point. Best practices are implement cloud financial management, adopt a consumption model. Mostly we're using a consumption model in AWS. Measure efficiency, so you can constantly measure, see if you are optimizing your systems for cost. Are you using the right pricing models? Have you over-allocated resources and so on? Stop spending money on undifferentiated heavy lifting. So if you're building your own data center, implementing your own infrastructure and managing it, well, that's not really differentiated. That's stuff which is not delivering value to your business. AWS would prefer that you don't waste your time and your money on that, and instead you concentrate on higher value things like developing better features and applications for your customers to differentiate your business. And lastly, analyze and attribute expenditure. So this is about being able to look at your itemized billing and understand what your costs are and where exactly they're coming from. And that's it for the five pillars of the well-architected framework. And do make sure that you remember the best practices associated with each of these pillars.